So, hello and welcome back to another episode of Jupiter's Alice 4. We're of course playing with the Amina Fantasy mod as Estelle. And we are we're still at war with Corintar, as you might see. But I have also made a decision already, a very important one. That is, this is not gonna go away, this occupation. These guys are gonna stay at war forever. I know that from experience. These two nations are gonna stay at war forever until I do something, basically. I will gonna get the call for peace soon enough. In like 2 years or something. Three, who knows? And then I'm just gonna stand there, kind of waiting. And they are not gonna do peace because they actually don't get a call for peace or anything. These guys actually don't get harmed whatsoever during this process. That is just AI doing their stuff as always, their magic. So I'm just gonna say screw it. And nosy be those bastards. So, let's get our occupation here so we can at least take that. You might hear me being a little bit pissed off about things, and I can tell you that it is not only this is the reason that I'm pissed off. You will see the reason soon enough. But for now, we're gonna of course keep repaying those loans. I mean, to be honest, we've kind of gotten a little bit of stuff done there. A little bit too much, maybe. I will see. Just gotta take those points as always. That's just the right, feels like the right choice every time. Alright, these guys of course are also doing the war. We can end this war. So, we're gonna take these provinces, that should be enough here. We're also gonna pillage your capital because screw you. War operations. Here we go. We don't care about this one alliance that they have, I have to admit. Royal patronage. Sure, innovativeness does not hurt. You guys are just gonna stand around here and clean things up. So, we can end this war. Give me money, pillage capital. To be it. Isn't it weird that I'm not checking the aggressive expansion impact of all of that? Isn't that weird? Isn't that strange that I'm not doing that? That's so weird. Alright, let's get this stuff caught. We can clean up the stability soon enough. And what's this exactly? Not this. There we go. On the 6th. Okay. We're not doing that. We're not pushing anywhere further here. Well, at least we have all of Kostanov under our belt. That's always very nice. The AI is helping us cleaning up around here. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Just need to build a mage tower in North Kastanov. And then we should be going alright. Can push a little bit further along here and get all of this stuff. Also, I'm gonna improve you. Gonna get a better zombie horde. I mean, the morale does recover very quickly. Yeah, current house is just getting cleaned up now. By the last dudes. This feels a little bit... little. And we do have a chunky amount of interest. There we go, this war's also over. We can do this one, right? Yeah. And we also got a little bit of money out of that war. Well, that's nice. That's pretty nice. Sure. I mean, we're already at 41 here, which is fantastic. I'm not sure which one of these do we need to get to... lower... north. The tax needs to be at 15 at least. Well, that still needs a little bit of work. Oh, there we already have some rebels coming up. Alright. Where is it? Oh, this is already gone. Okay. We're also gonna do the Curse Expansion and the Golden Era right away. That just makes sense. Let's clean up the stability. Should be very simple. Of course, we still have a little bit more going on here, but... there's reasons for that. there are some decent reasons for that. Alright, let me just quickly do something here. Also, now I'm curious about that. So, the reason I'm pissed off, you will soon enough see. We failed. Now, I've been clicking this a little bit quickly, so you didn't have time to actually see what's going on there. Let me just quickly load that again for you. You see, we have failed at the attempt of Lichdom. Let's load this quickly again. Because the event itself gives me a percentage of chance of what basically... what how high the chances are of me succeeding. But of course we are playing with the Steam version. So save scumming does not work. As simple as that. That's just how this works. But what I'm pissed off about is this. 80%. 80% chance for this to succeed. Isn't that cool? We failed an 80% chance, so sad enough. Our high mage fails. Well, what can you do? Fucking bullshit. Like I said, there are reasons why I'm pissed off. We're gonna continue with the idea cost. We still have military ones. Let's not get even more unrest. Now, one thing that I'm actually curious about. So we no longer have Witch King. But we can keep the undead army under control, luckily enough. And of course we do that. The necromancers help out there. That's at least a positive thing, but sad enough, Vadina dead. I mean, the main issue in my eyes here is currently that I really feel discouraged to try it again. I did spend a lot of resources on becoming a lich. And the game just, well, then just tells me, tough luck. So, I mean, I still have things to become a lich. Like, I get bonuses for being a lich. I can get this permanent modifier and stuff like that. And permanent modifiers are fairly cool, but... Maybe I feel a little bit better when some time has passed. Let's face it like that. Maybe I feel more inclined to attempt something then. How old are you? 40? You might, there might be a chance for you. I mean, it depends on how much necromancy he has. Because after all, we do need to reach legendary necromancy first. Before we can pursue lichdom. At least we can keep up the army of the undead. That's the only, that's also important. Current separatists, they should be coming up soon enough, so I'm gonna keep my armies focused. Also, we can just quickly do the claim here. Okay, that took... Okay, whatever. Sure. What other conflict could we might have? Rivenheart. I mean, we do need to do a little bit to get the our claims rolling. Those are all our claims at the moment. Our normal that we just created. But when we have this stuff organized, we are looking a little bit brighter. Right? Watch documents. Oh no. Oh no, that's so terrible. I could just wait for this one to finish and then I do the stability one. I mean, stability should be alright with us. Obviously. There should be no major problem. The claims should come around... Where do claims show up? And this gives me that. This makes lower cost enough. Wait, where are my claims? There are my claims. Yeah, we need to build up Southgate with a castle. It should not prove too difficult, to be honest. There we go. I can also clean up lower cost enough. That's one loan. Repaid again. Come on. Cast enough, do it.
Do it.
So, can get at one stability, so everything grows. And now, we should get something else actually. First of all, let's get a lot of armies for now. We can make use of that. We need devastation gone. Alright, you probably have still a lot of devastation, but that goes down. That goes down, no worries. I don't care. Don't tell me about this stuff again. I don't care if you're the Emperor. I have better things to do than to listen to that shenanigan. Alright, now, but now we can stop paying the army and really make some decent cash. That should be gone soonish. At least when this is gone, right? How long does this actually last, Death of a Witch King? 10 years. Ouch. Then how do we... I mean, we can get positive stability. We of course can also always do this. Get a mains back up again. Three more loans. That one should be now alright to pick. Still doesn't cost that as much as expected, so that's nice. With military points we're just gonna hold up. And let that grow. Alright, 3 more months and we are done with can finally do that. Get a cast enough area secured, get a cast enough princess in check. There we go. My friends. We can just say fuck it and throw them out. We can give them some influence, but far more likely will be doing that. We're gonna get the Castanar Patrician's estate. So, well, first of all of the negative modifiers are removed. Everyone is happy. Let's take a look at... Wait, I need to wait a month. Oh no, there they are. Cast enough princess. Well, first of all, there's one thing that we're gonna give you back, and that is this one. The extra points. So they're basically a fairly different merchant estate. We have they have a bunch of modifiers, or they have the usual modifiers, some fairly normal ones that they have, for example the city commerce and stuff like that they have. But they also have a bunch of modifiers that really focus on pushing up Kastonaf. For example, an interesting one would be this one right here. Own Kastonaf provinces get 20% development cost reduction, construction cost reduction, a possible number of manufactories, but they get unrest and monthly autonomy. This is one that I think I'm gonna take right away. Glorify old Kastonarian culture. That might actually also... You know what? That's also alright. It's prestige. That's basically a better version of the prestige thingy. So. You also have autonomy. But I also give goods produced quite a bit in Kastonaf. This is tax income in Kastonaf. Kastonaf first increases state maintenance, but does give another bunch of development cost reduction and governing costs and state maintenance and stuff like that. You know what? Sure. Kastonaf recruitment you don't want. So I think I'm alright with what we have at the moment. We could also just do private fleet, right? Trade steering and stuff like that? Sure. Because with that, you guys should get a fairly chunky reduction of development. We also get a petition guard. Still 89. I mean, we are at 41, I agree on that, but... So we have the... we have the Kastonaf first, which gives development cost reduction and governing costs and stuff like that. Lax building regulations, which gives another 20%. And then we just have cleanse again. This is actually surprisingly expensive, but these guys are cheap. Okay, there we have what we have. I guess there's still a lot more to still more development cost reduction to gain. The only thing, of course, might become problematic is the... Actually, no, that is a capital state. It's not gonna be problematic. Yeah, the autonomy we should not worry about too much. Mage Tower is the next thing on the list. And we don't want you to occupy anything. I'm actually willing to risk that. We should not lose much morale. Oh yeah, of course, we're zombies. Right, I forgot. We recover within seconds. Right, there was something. How are we looking on this one? I mean, we currently have a mage coming up here. The question is how long this guy is gonna stay alive. I mean, you're 67, mate. You could die if you want to. I wouldn't mind. You of course have to reduce research regulation. Nope. Let's throw them all out. Paying or not paying? I mean, to be honest, the difference between our army's full strength and not is just a month. We have seen that. We have clearly seen that. I mean, of course, we want to catch up here now. We have the colonialism to punch in anyway. Everything needs 20 development as well. I might be just alright to push that here already. I mean, we have a lot of Diplo points. Actually, we can wait until these are on their limits. There's no need to not do that. It should also be my main trade center right now. Yeah, I mean, of course, later on we're gonna change that to over here. Because it just makes more sense. And for now, Kastonaf. Okay, that's interesting. I guess we're gonna have to pay the army then. So we don't accidentally get jumped on. Who started that war? Losheria. Wait. You're my ally. But you are, that's so crazy. I would have I'm a witch king. I was more like a small child being upset about this. I mean, yeah, I don't think that we want the other stuff. I mean, that's also something important. It is absolutism that's gonna get reduced, obviously. And absolutism is very valuable sometimes. I just beat each other up. I'm completely alright with that. We are gonna repay the last bits of our loans, then we aim for towards the mage tower. And then we can finally push along here, get a capital rolling, get some admin, get a little bit more here rolling. Yep, 20 development and everything. Which is not too difficult to achieve, like I said. You are cheaper because you have cloth. I think then I'm gonna probably get the colonialism spawned here. Yep. I think South Kasnov is the one that needs the push anyway. Ah, where is it? Oh, it needs manpower. Okay, alright. Yeah? Okay. That's a very decent decision to make. I mean, I have to say about this Lichdom thingy, I tried a bit. I tried like four times to get it done, but we cannot save scum, obviously, in the Steam version. Because I really wanted to get that done. I mean, that I was very excited for that, to get like the person who started all of this to be my lich, but. We can't have everything in life. Castle is dead. Well, I didn't want stability anyway. RIP Castle. Luckily enough, we should have a decent reduction here with this ability. I'm not gonna let anyone run around here. Oh, that's a lot of peasants. Now look at how these guys are melting each other. That's the kind of... I mean, we're not gonna lose morale. I'll tell you that. There we go. That just doesn't happen. But luckily nobody else tries to get in here. Oh wow. Clouded Eye just pushing you guys around. That's embarrassing. Let's take this goblin in here. Alright, goblins, talking about that. We probably want to push them out, don't we? Ah, these guys are all waltzing around, but I think we can expand very simply as soon as we get a few things ordered. Let's build spy network. 120 years. I mean, we need to get this kind of done fairly quickly, don't we? 500 for you. But a lot cheaper in Kastanov. Okay, only 400. Alright. Coronite proclamation. That's gonna happen. We can rebuild the North Citadel, not now. That's gonna be rather annoying. I mean, I don't have much... I mean, to be honest, we don't have much to do with religion anyway. We could technically become Coronite, right? I mean, it's been a while since I've done that. I need the money, so no. There's nothing to do with religion here anywhere. I'm also not sure about what we have later on, but I think I'm gonna be alright with that. Yeah. Oh, I'm at war. And this war, please. I need to convert. I want a send of reformation. I mean, to be honest, we've done a lot of region court recently. Did I? Did I do it on YouTube? That's the question. I mean, I've played a lot of region court myself. That's the thingy. That's what I want to say with that. And I'm kind of alright with that. It's been a while since I've done Coronite. I think I'm gonna go Coronite with these guys. We can always switch later on when I'm not feeling it. I think I'll get rid of these guys. I mean, that also works. Okay. Alright. My good man. I mean, these guys usually have bad stats, but I do want to push on the right path here. I can still pick Castellos. I mean, this also doesn't matter too much. But we obviously are gonna study. Are you even a mage? Okay, yeah, you are. I guess we need a monthly tick for this one to come around. Or to be aware of it at least. There we go. Alright, he's talented. He's at least talented in necromancy. Well. Let's spend... I'd need the money. Let's spend Diplo points. Oh, come on! How often is this event gonna come up? It costs a lot. Don't be like that, guys. Oh! They kind of just remembered that I'm a Witch King. Okay, cool. I guess because we now have a mage with necromancy in charge. I see. That's good. Let's give this a try again, then. Means our army is just gonna punch up again. I mean, we need to keep the Witch King stuff around, obviously. Because that's how we're gonna form the Black Demons. That's how you pronounce that. Who is also part of this war? Counts League, Elegance. Oh. We're at war with each other. Why are you friendly towards me? I mean, yeah, I know that they're doing all of these weird things and stuff like that, but they're good guys, technically, if you think about it. I mean, to be honest, I actually wouldn't mind some territory from the Council League. I mean, I don't have claims or anything on it, but hey. Territory is territory. We're also, of course, gonna step up. 10! 10! 10! Do I just push up to 3? Oh, well, that was fast. Okay. We'll see. If they're gonna be friendly enough to give us anything. Nah. A shame. But I guess they cleaned up a little bit here. Someone died. We need... I mean, these guys feel fairly meaningless, Diplo reputation. You cannot fix my Diplo reputation. We're already hated by everything and everyone. Okay, but this one is not gonna come around anytime soon, so I think, at least on this note... Oh wait, there's innovativeness to take. I like innovativeness. And if we can get it up early... That of course is always very interesting. Actually, we could... finally we could build the tower in the capital, because we know that South Customers will turn into the capital. Oh, but okay, yeah, forget it. I guess we're also gonna end the episode here anyway. So like always, like Dungeon Shenanigans, I guess you guys next episode. Bye!